Light is probably one of the most important things in our world. And even though we might not be able to fully understand it, it's definitely an important part of human culture. Its importance can be traced back throughout history and has definitely been a huge contributor to humanity's development. From the development of civilization to the birth of the internet, light is definitely something we take for granted, and we'd definitely be in a dark place right now if it just ceased to exist. As a medical student, I often need light on a daily basis to get work done, and this is where my idea for this video began. I've been studying for a long time, but only recently I've started to notice that some of my friends prefer to get work done in a bright room, whilst others prefer a bit more darkness.
You merely adopted the dark. I was born in it.
This made me a bit curious, as I wanted to know if our lighting conditions can actually affect our ability to get work done, and if so, by how much. However, before I get into that, I need to introduce myself. My name is Damien, I'm a fourth year medical student, and I'm here to help you answer the question, does lighting affect productivity? First of all, we know that light affects the human body in many ways, from sunlight being involved in the production of vitamin D to the way light interacts with our circadian rhythm, which I'll come back to later. Light also contributes to our mental health. A 2014 study found that people who had windows in their office exercised more, got more sleep, and had a greater sense of overall well-being compared to people who worked in offices with no windows. Poor office lighting in general also has a tendency to lead to fatigue, drowsiness, poor sleep, and eye strain. In severe cases, darkness could contribute to a condition called seasonal affective disorder, which is when people experience increased levels of depression during the winter months as a result of the reduced daylight. There are three mechanisms that are disrupted to cause this effect. The first mechanism that is disrupted is the circadian rhythm. The circadian rhythm is basically the internal body clock and a response to changes between light and dark to regulate your sleep, mood, and appetite. The longer nights and shorter days of winter can disrupt your internal clock, leaving you feeling groggy, disorientated, and sleepy at inconvenient times. Also, when it's dark, your brain produces the hormone melatonin to help you sleep. And then sunlight during the day triggers the brain to stop melatonin production, so you feel awake and alert. During the short days and long nights of winter, however, your body may produce too much melatonin, leaving you feeling drowsy and low on energy. The reduced sunlight can also lower your body's production of serotonin as well, which is also known as the happy hormone, a neurotransmitter that helps to regulate mood. A deficit of serotonin may lead to depression and also affects your sleep, appetite, memory, and libido. Depression and low mood is extremely important when it comes to productivity. As we all know, it's really hard to get work done when you're in a low mood. In general, there are a lot of studies that show that people perform better cognitively in brighter environments. But there was one study in particular that stood out to me, where scientists studied the brain of Nile grass rats, which are nocturnal, just like us humans. They put one group of rats in a dimly lit environment for 4 weeks, whilst another group was put in a brightly lit environment for 4 weeks. What do you think happened? Well, the rats who spent time in dim light lost about 30% of the capacity of their hippocampus, which is a region of the brain that plays a vital role in transferring information to the memory. The rats also found it quite hard to swim in a water maze, which is something that they were previously able to do perfectly. That sounds pretty grim, doesn't it? In contrast, the rodents who spent time in a brightly lit environment actually improved their performance compared to before. However, the good news is that the changes in the rats weren't permanent for those that were put in a dimly lit environment. When the researchers gave the rats a break from the dim light for a month and then exposed them to bright light, their brains actually recovered, and they regained their ability to do all the tasks that they were previously able to do without any clear permanent damage. We already know that people perform better cognitively in brighter lighting environments, but I believe this study helps to keep this fact in perspective. The other aspect of light that is important to discuss is its color temperature. Color temperature is normally depicted in Kelvin, and the higher the color temperature, the brighter and cooler the light will be. This is referred to as blue light, or a cool temperature, whilst lower Kelvin levels represent warmer lights. In the case of light, warm and cold don't refer to the physical heat of the lamp or light source, but to the tone or color of the light. A high color temperature triggers the release of serotonin, which affects our mood and energy levels. When used intelligently, blue light can be ideal for those spaces where the mind needs to work at full speed. such as meeting rooms, even study rooms, office spaces, and even factories, where high concentration is expected and needed. If you want to increase productivity and promote a positive environment, short blue wavelengths are what you want. This is backed up by the fact that studies have shown that students in cooler lighting environments perform better compared to students in warmer lighting environments. In contrast, a low color temperature triggers the production and release of melatonin, which allows us to unwind, relax, and become sleepy. Low color temperatures are often referred to as warm red light and occur naturally at the end of the day. This light is really helpful for when someone is trying to sleep or wind down. However, nowadays we constantly have bright blue lights around us, from TV screens to smartphones. This excessive inconvenient light is called light pollution and can lead to a lot of issues such as poor sleep quality and eye strain. However, the thing is, neither form of light is better than the other, but by choosing the right light colors at the right time of the day, you can boost your body's ability to remain alert and active when appropriate, and also relax when necessary. A lot of screens and computers also have an option built into them that allow you to reduce the amount of blue light that is being emitted from the screen. However, stepping away from lights or screens in general would probably be a better option if you're trying to improve your quality of sleep. I'm just going to finish off this video by saying that even though this video is based on how lighting affects productivity, it's also important to observe how the type of lighting you surround yourself with could also affect things such as your mental health and sleep quality, which are even more important than maximizing how much work you can get done in a day. And that brings us to the end of the video. I found it really interesting to see how something that literally has no mass or weight can affect our bodies so much. If you liked the video, I'd really appreciate it if you liked the video and subscribed, as there are a lot more videos still on the way. Also, let me know in the comments if there's anything that you'd want me to improve or you'd like to see me cover any other topics. But anyways, that's it for me. I'll see you in the next video. Peace.